property we applied for and currently live in, we viewed for approximately 10 minutes. Moving in and being able to turn on the lights and see what it truly looks like was a bit of a shock. With the lights on, we could clearly see the black mould throughout the entire house, bathroom, walls, ceiling, windows, a gaping rotting hole in the floorboards by the fireplace, which was black and wet from all the rain coming down, and a dilapidated fireplace with dead bird remains inside. Every time I've gone to VCAT, the process has been mentally exhausting. At every step, I've had to meticulously document all of the issues, take photos, videos, keep emails, document all evidence and be prepared to fight for myself.
These days, we're looking at kind of backups in VCAT of sort of 2 years. You know, you won't get a hearing for that length of time. Any bond claims, you want to get a bond. As soon as your rental provider says, we're not going to give you your bond back, then you have to go to VCAT. And that means, like, I got my bond back for my previous property 12 months later.
I think the biggest thing about being a renter that I can say is that it's never easy to find a place. It doesn't matter how good the market is, there's always competition. And you're always scrabbling to find something. You put in applications for places that you don't really want or that don't suit your needs or are not suitable in a number of ways, because if you don't, you might miss out and have no one to move to. I think now the situation's a lot worse than it was.
Obviously with rising rent, I understand that prices are going up for everyone. And I understand supply and demand and things like that, but it is a tough pill to swallow when your rent's going up by 20-30% year on year. You're just looking to sort of consider whether you need to leave your job and move back to another city to live with your parents or just move way too far to kind of commute. It is quite tough.
When interest rates were going down rapidly, my rent was still going up faster than CPI, faster than inflation. With interest rates now increasing, my rents are still going up faster than inflation, far faster than the wage prices index and my wages. With a CPI of 7%, my rent increase this month was even higher, 10%. Despite the restrictions and the allowable reasoning applied to rent increases, my agent was still allowed to say, we're increasing the rent to your poor quality house in Coburg North to match those high quality newer builds in Coburg North in better parts of your suburb.
And I'm paying 94% of my income on rent. My savings will not last too many years, you know, another couple, and I do. I look at bridges. I look at railway bridges to see if there's a safe place I could camp.